kapten pas lagi keluar kan, lagi ngobrol-ngobrol sama orang mesin kan, sambil minum-minum. Posisi kayak rombongan saya yang lagi kerja kan, banyak lumba-lumba kan. Ujung-ujungnya lama-lama marah kan. Marah. Udah seminggu nggak ada apa namanya penghasilan. Ditembakin semuanya dari laut.
The Chinese distant water fishing fleet is the largest in the world, with thousands of vessels operating in every ocean, catching millions of tons of fish every year. And it's become notorious in recent years for cruel, illegal, and ecologically destructive fishing practices, with hundreds of Chinese vessels implicated in multiple regions across the world. Often these reports are accompanied by accounts of severe human rights violations and labor abuses.
Ini tempat processing ikan. Kami ditempatkan di sini tidurnya.
The Southwest Indian Ocean. A biodiversity hotspot that's home to thousands of unique marine species and where millions of people rely on the sea for food and income. Over the past decade, China has been investing heavily in the region, leveraging its abundant resources through initiatives that were often hailed as mutually beneficial. The licensing of Chinese fishing vessels as part of a broader investment in the region's blue economy was also championed by both the Chinese and local governments as a means to uplift local communities and boost economic prosperity. But despite publicly promising a zero-tolerance approach to illegal fishing within its distant water fleet, an investigation by the Environmental Justice Foundation has revealed human rights abuses and ecological harm on an industrial scale.
Gunanya si lampu ini jadi untuk menarik ikan tuna yang besar. Ketika memakai alat ini, kebanyakan yang nyangkut di lampu ini itu tuna, seperti itu.
Dan pemakaian ini itu dilarang di perairan Tanzania sana.
Karena ini tidak boleh, oleh kepolisian pun dicari ketika ada kapal yang memakai lampu seperti ini. Begitu.
Operasi ke Tanzania, ada polisi, dua orang yang naik ke kapal, memeriksa kapal. Sebelum polisi datang, orang-orang Cinanya membuang sirip hiu 1,5 karung. Setelah itu, ngumpetin pancing lampu, entah 3 basket apa 4 basket. Tanya kan itu dilarang, nggak boleh.
Ini kan daerah operasi mancing di sana juga populasi hiu cukup banyak.
Iya.
Pernah nggak, atau misalnya kapal mas ini masih menangkap ikan hiu masih sebagai tangkapan?
Kalau hiu tetap ditangkap, mereka ambil siripnya doang, badannya dibuang. Kayak gitu operasinya sih, semuanya kayak gitu.
Kalau satu tarikan terkadang sampai hampir 20 masuk.
Jadi kita taruh di tong gesek itu freezer lah, es, terus dikumpulin pak, terus sampai sandar kaptennya yang jual pak.
Ada hiu martil, ada hiu cucut yang hiu biru itu, hiu air, yang hiu coklat. Banyak ya jenis hiunya kan yang masuk ke situ. Kalau nggak ada ikan tuna, ada hiunya semua.
EJF interviews with the Indonesian crew members who work on Chinese longliners in the Southwest Indian Ocean have revealed widespread illegal practices, such as fishing illegally in prohibited zones, the use of destructive banned fishing gear, and the intentional targeting of protected species.
Kalau dari tiga jenis penyu ini, penyu jenis mana Kang yang suka diambil dan dimasak itu?
Ini, bawahnya.
Berarti Olive Ridley. Hmm. Dia itu di bagian dadanya itu berarti dia disembelih dulu kah atau langsung dibuka badannya begitu?
Langsung dibuka badannya.
Berarti tanpa dibunuh dulu?
Iya.
Saji, sampai bahkan 4 saji dibunuh. Ya kan diambil giginya aja. Itu untuk kaptennya sendiri sih dijual ke, kan ada bisnis sama kapal temennya itu.
Alongside the widespread illegal fishing uncovered by the investigation is an exploitation of a different kind. As China's economy boomed in recent decades, Chinese crew members, seeking better wages and working conditions, were replaced by migrant workers, mostly from Indonesia and the Philippines. Initially lured by the promise of better wages than they could expect at home, workers end up trapped in debt bondage by exploitative contracts on board Chinese distant water fishing vessels for years at a time. They often borrow many thousands of dollars to cover travel, accommodation, and administration fees, which they must then work off over the course of their multi-year contracts. Miles away from shore and safety, vulnerable crews are then exposed to a vicious cycle of exploitation and abuse, with no means of escape.
Ya, kalau di kapal Cina nggak ada kata istirahat. Kecuali ABK nggak kerja. Kalau nggak ABK nggak kerja, ya nggak dikasih makan.
Terkadang kerjanya ada yang 18 jam, kadang 19 jam. Ikan banyak, kadang 22 jam nyampe. Oh, kalau ini pertama kali saya kerja gulung-gulung nilon. Ini enggak pakai sarung tangan.
Kenapa enggak pakai sarung tangan?
Soalnya kan enggak dibolehin sama mandornya. Harus tangan kosong gitu katanya. Nah, itu selama 4 bulan.
Despite injuries and illness that often stem from extreme working hours and a lack of safety measures, crew members are compelled to keep working. Intimidation and violence are common. Confrontations can escalate rapidly, and the silent struggles of individual crew members are largely ignored.
Ibaratnya kayak arogan gitu, aluminium, sering ngajakin ribut ya gitu, Pak. Mengancam kayak dia megang pisau, megang bambu apa segala macam ya, gancoy gitu, Pak.
Pas masuknya telat, jadi mandornya marah-marah, bukulin, pakainya pakai besi. Pas besinya segini.
Kita di tengah laut terus itu. Ada salah satu ABK minta pulang sama kapten tuh, minta pulang, terus nggak boleh. Udah satu udah nggak tahan, mungkin karena anak ada pengaruh. Sekitar 3 minggu itu dia itu, selama itu tuh dia tuh. Si pas lihat kontrol jaga itu udah nggak ada di kamarnya tuh. Udah nggak ada kan, akhirnya dilihatlah CCTV itu, dicari sekitar kejadian sekitar jam berapa tuh, di sekitar jam 6.20 kalau nggak salah tuh dia terjunnya tuh.
For generations, coastal communities in Southwest Indian Ocean nations have depended on the sea. But the environmental and human toll of the Chinese distant water fleet in their waters now poses a serious threat to the blue economy here. To ensure that the region's fragile marine ecosystems are preserved and that human rights on board distant water fishing vessels are respected, the Chinese government must act now to enforce its own laws and introduce critical transparency measures to eradicate these systemic abuses across its fleet. Southwest Indian Ocean nations should also adopt increased transparency and sustainability measures to protect their waters and the people who depend on them.